stage with the world famous Moron Brothers. Hey, what's going on now, folks? We got what we got planned here on this baseball song. We was poor growing up. I told you a while ago, we had as many kids in our family. We had our own baseball team. And we was poor. We used to poor when we was little babies, our daddy tried to breastfeed us, but I think he was a moron. I don't know.
How about that food? Now that food good, wasn't it?
Yeah, good.
We got in Arkansas back in the summer. We went to this big steakhouse they told us about. We all ordered a steak. Old boy come through and set mine down, my wife, Arnold's wife. Arnold says, hey, I ordered a steak too. Old boy said, I know, I'll be right back. He come walking through there and he had his thumb right on top of it like he said, man, Lord said, hey, you got the thumb on top of my steak. Old boy said, I know, I want to make sure I don't drop it again.
Hey, we stay at motels all over the country, everywhere we go, you know, traveling around. And I don't think nobody here in Arkansas, but we found a redneck Hilton out there, boy. Man, it was a rough place. I know we was in trouble. We walked in the front door, there's a roach run out there, had a dead mouse in his mouth. He's a biggin. We stand in the lobby checking in. I told Burley, I was looking at that one-eyed dog coming in the door. He said, I think that dog's going out the door. Might be Oklahoma, maybe. I don't know. But you saw a big bug, didn't you?
Yeah, I spent like a gas book and a bed bug come crawling right down the middle of the gas book.
Oh, that rough.
Told that old gal, I said, we stayed in one of the motels with bed bugs. It's the first time we ever had one come down the front and see what room we're going to stay in.
It got worse. We got to the room, I couldn't believe it. I had to call the front desk. I said, buddy, I got a leak in the sink. He said, go ahead.
I remember when I was a lad, what a great baseball team we had. People came from miles around to watch us play. Went White Sox, beat the Sox off, played the Astros, not think it rained that day. Then we first played, Mom played second, brother and sister, pitcher and catcher. So I stopped playing my good old ball in 82. In the outfield shaking, five, three deep on the hip guy. Brothers Art, Mark, Cub, Fargo, too. At the barnyard we go to learn to pitch and catch and throw. There was cows and horses all over the place. We all laughed until we split when our daddy got a hit and slid into what he thought was second base. Daddy played first base, Mom played second. Brother and sister was pitcher and catcher. Shortstop played by a good old mama named Sue. In the outfield shaking, five, three big home run hit guy. Brothers Art, Mark, Cub, Fargo, too. One time I had to take first place. He got hurt playing third base. We drug him in a shade, laid him in the grass. Big base runner come sliding in. He had big sharp bites on him. He tore Burley's overalls and cut his face. Dad played first base, Mom played second. Brother and sister, pitcher and catcher. Shortstop played by a good old boy named Sue. In the outfield shaking, five, three big home run hit guy. Brothers Art, Mark, Cub, Fargo, too. Brothers Art, Mark, Cub, Fargo, too. Told me before we got married you was well off. You lied to me. He said I was. I didn't have sense enough to know it.
Boy, my wife, man, she been mad at me. Let me tell y'all men something now. If your hearing is slipping a little bit, get you a hearing aid before you get in trouble with your women. The other day, my wife hollered in there at me. She said, "I'm proud of you." I said, "I'm tired of you too." Don't go too good in peace.
He went in there all night, put his contact lens in a glass of water by the sink. She come to her a few minutes later to take her medicine to drink. Said she walked around 2 days in 20/20 hindsight.
I'm going to share this with you. Women ain't with us, so I'm going to tell you. Mine was having these problems with mood swings, you know. What's the deal with that, fellas? Mood swing. She couldn't tell how to act. I'd come in, you know, she'd be different every time. Knucklehead there, he said, get her one of his mood rings. It'll change colors with her mood. Well, them things kind of work. Boy, when it was green, she'd be in the sweetest mood ever was. But Hoss, if she's in a bad mood, it'd leave all of his red spot right there.
Y'all know why Solomon had so many wives? He's only come home, find at least one of them in a good mood.
We found out what was wrong with her, though. We told my buddy I'd take her to the doctor over at my buddy's house, and she was looking at one of his coin collections, and she had a Kennedy half dollar right up there in her face right, looking at it. Well, she got the coughing and everything. It flew in her mouth. She swallowed that thing. She passed a quarter, two dimes, and a nickel. The doc said she was going through the change. He's going through the change. Woo, boy. That's all.
You know, like I said, one morning, Adam was walking around paradise. He had a little boy with him. They walked by the Garden of Eden. Little boy said, "Woo, Daddy, look at that place. That sure is pretty." He said, "I know, son. That's where we used to live. The mama eat us out of house and home."
Yeah, I know what we ain't done. Well, I was living old grandfather's clock.
Right,
that's a pretty old song.
Now, mind me, over at home, yes, I was going in the Walmart store. By the time
we pulled in the parking lot, and there was a guy pushing about 20-30 of them carts across there. He hollered at him and said, "Hey, buddy, don't you think somebody else want to use one of them?" Stupid. Go ahead.
Walmart over at home yesterday, getting ready to go in by the time I got up to the door.
They had the blood mobile in there. They were giving blood, you know, taking blood, people. It's a good thing if you can do that. Give blood. I went up there going to give some blood. And I seen an old boy sitting in there. He wasn't from around there. They was drawing blood out of his arm. And I said, "Pal, you're not from around here, are you?" He said, "No, I'm Cherokee, North Carolina." I said, "You a Cherokee Indian?" He said, "Yeah." I said, "Full blooded?" He said, "Not right now, I'm about a half pint low." Go ahead.
Yeah, go home. I'm getting ready to go to the Walmart store. By the time I get up,
when we got in there, there's a guy. He'd been to the doctor, and he had a patch on his eye. And I told Burley, you know, he'd been to the doctor, had that patch on his eye. I said, "Burley, look at that guy with one eye." He said, "Okay, world." Go ahead.
Over at home yesterday, getting ready to go to the dollar store. Yeah, I come walking out of our kind grandfather's clock. He was rear back strut. This old drunk come around the corner, run into him, knocked him down, broke his grandfather's clock all over the sidewalk. Oh, I got mad. He jumped up, hollered, "Won't you, boy, where are you going?" Old drunk said, "Won't you carry pocket watch like I do?"
My grandfather's coffin was too tall to hold a chair, so he stood many years on the floor. Was taller by far than you. crawling on the floor, for the day she was born. And always a treasure in pride. But it stopped once down the road on the day that the old man died. 9 years without slumbering, life's second slumbering. TV, a free thing you get on the internet. It's the moronbrothers.carbontv.com. All kind of YouTube stuff on there. Get your Moron Brothers products at the moronbrothersstore.com. I'm telling you, son, up till we hooked up with this guy that's helping us, closest thing to the internet we could get was a internet I had down in the boat, but
we got a new deputy sheriff over at home. And the other day they sent him out on his first domestic call. He called in on the radio and said, "Sheriff, I've got a situation out here." He said, "What's the matter?" He said, "This lady just shot her husband because he walked across the floor while she was mopping him." He said, "Did you arrest her?" He said, "Well, not yet. I'm waiting on that floor to dry."
You know, I was thinking back there about the preacher. I'll tell you about our preacher there last Sunday. Go to a little country church there in Jessamine County and got a real pastor, Brother Bill Bales. He's a good fella there at the church we go to. But you know how them preachers are, every once in a while they get carried away and won't hush.
I know somebody like that.
Anyway, he got to going last Sunday and I felt bad, you know. He was jumping from one book to the Bible and just kept on and going on 1 o'clock. Said, "I gotta do something, send him a message." And I picked up a hymn book and I hauled off and throwed it right up through the church. Tried to break his train of thought, but I accidentally hit an elderly woman right in the back of the head with it. Knocked her out on the floor. I run up there, I said, "Ma'am, are you all right?" She said, "Hit me again, I still hear him a little bit."
We're going to do on here is my grandson's favorite song. When he started first grade, they took him to the cafeteria and had a big bowl of apples. Boy, he loves apples. Teacher told him, said, "Lucas, just get one, God watching." Well, he got him an apple and went after yonder. Got that on the end, had a great big bowl of cookies. He told his buddy, said, "Get all these cookies you want. God's watching them apples."
Oh, he's been hanging around him being like that boy.
His mama put cold cream on the face one night. He said, "What you done that for, mama?" She said, "Well, I'm trying to make myself be more beautiful." And then she took some Kleenex, started wiping it off. He said, "What'd you do? Give up?"
What did he say to her about that mouse, huh?
Oh, yeah, he come out to me the other night. He said, "Paul, how much water does a mouse have in it?"
Yeah.
I said, "I don't know, about half a thimble, I reckon." He said, "No, he's got more than that." I said, "How you know?" He said, "One just ran up Granny's pink leg." He said, "She caught it right there and squeezed it, and I bet you 2 gallon run out of it."
We got one here about one of our favorite things to eat growing up. I told you how poor we was. It was bad. We was pitiful poor. Tell about our little brother.
Oh, we had a little brother. Mama, a lot of times, wouldn't have nothing to cook for supper. And she set all those little kids on her table and read recipes to us. Our little brother was hard of hearing. He almost starved to death.
There was a bunch of us kids, and he was the youngest one, the last one. Last bunch of kids Mama had, she had 4 at one time. And Daddy said, "What we gonna name them?" Mama said, "I'm gonna name these last 4 myself." She called them Rudolph, Adolph, Get Off, and Stay Off.
Oh, here we go. You got
that one? Yeah.
Y'all know what you got when you got a harmonica player up to your neck in concrete? Not enough concrete.
I've been working all day in the hot sun. I can only wait for night to come. We keep you awake, Pat.
No, he ain't by me, go ahead. Time you get done that bitch sleep.
You yawned all day. I mean, it's aggravating. What, didn't you get no sleep last night?
About 4 o'clock this morning before I went to sleep.
Why is that?
When the shade was up in the window.
Why'd you pull them down?
They was in the wind across the street.
Me and Gene will be over tonight. Yeah. It's so hot you can't sleep, it's hotter than far. You ought to hear that old Kentucky River bullfrog holler. Kentucky River bullfrog, bigger than the ground on call, like a coon dog barking on a tree. Can't you wicked fire man, throw him in a frying pan. Kentucky River bullfrog, mighty good to eat. With me and my uncle in the car by life, battle down the river in the field of moonlight. Catch a bass of bull rock, take him home tomorrow. We eat broad day when the morning comes. Kentucky River bull rock, bigger than the ground. Bar collar like a coon dog, parking on the creek. Catch a wicked fire man, throw him in a frying pan. Kentucky River bull rock, mighty good to eat. Oh, to meet them all, and we took them in, and you ought to see my fat big grin. Kentucky River Bulldog, bigger than a groundhog, I like to drop for a home tree. Catch you with your bare hand, going to the front of Kentucky River Bulldog, man, good day. About all the frog, we gonna take up a reach for a frog, come up with a snake, plunk that snake down in the bowl, hit him in the head with my bull door. Can't do it, you river bullfrog, bigger than a ground frog, holler like a dog, bark on a tree, catch you with your bare hand, throw him in a brown man, tug a river bullfrog, a man to see. Check us out on the computer there. We appreciate it. We got some stuff out here too. Come see us.
Y'all be careful driving home because we're walking.
You are.
Ladies and gentlemen, the morning.